overarching perspective that we think could improve strength and conditioning as an industry, as a culture, is a perpetual max effort method. And the sentence we put on that is why partially try. The way that I think about it is, if we have 10 reps allocated for something, why would we not put everything we possibly can into those 10 reps? If the effort that we exert would be better suited for a 20 rep set, then what we did is somehow diminish the effect that the 10 rep set is intended to have, right? Like when we know about basic strength and conditioning and what the brain does and what the body does, certain rep schemes elicit certain shit. Other rep schemes elicit other shit. There's such a thing as paralysis by analysis with that. If you get too much into that and not enough into the other, the movement details that complement the schemes, then we've missed it. But if what I'm doing is a 30 rep effort in a 5 rep set, I have not scaled that work to my ability. That is not a scheme appropriate effort. And therefore, it's not going to build the soundest foundation. Because you essentially bled the effort of those other 15 or 25 or 25 reps. So when we're moving this weekend, last point on the other, if the training is written properly, that's accommodated. If it's a 10 rep set, we expect that you're going to put your full entire ass into that 10 rep set, and the rest of the training day is built accordingly. It's not upside down in the sense that if you put your full ass into the first piece of training, you're going to get permanently injured in the third piece of training. But based on both experience and observation over a long period of time, that's what happens when the training is wrong hierarchy, order of operations inaccurate. With us, we want you to put full attention, as much surgical precision as you can muster into every rep you're doing, as much violence into every rep you're doing as possible. And when we say violence, what are we saying here? Forceful, aggressive, non-casual, with intent to injure. Not fast, careless, dramatic, hasty, emotional. So it's not flailing, tough guy face, roll on the ground. It's, am I braced? Is my posture strong? Am I using everything at my disposal to make this as valuable as you can make it? That's the main takeaway from us for the weekend, is did we elicit that in you? That should be the main takeaway. Is can you make yourself tired in 5 reps with something that used to make you tired in 20? That's the goal. Because most of us are not simply training because we want to exercise all the time. Some people are. I love training. But my goals in training are always to be better at that, to be more durable for this. Which means if you empty the tank every single day doing nerdy, goofy, overindulgent attrition drills, you won't have as much in the tank to perform the things that you want to perform. So that's where we start thinking about making less more with details and violence and consistency. All that makes sense, and it especially makes sense to anyone that's practiced our training with any sort of deliberate mindset. One of the constructive criticisms we get from the internet when people look at the training that we do but don't actually apply it is that it isn't enough. I'll take hands up because I think it's fun. How many of you looked at the training and before you'd done it thought that? All right, good. I accept that. I think there's more in that group, but I'll accept those hands up. And that's important because it really does look like that sometimes. But that's until you actually start checking every single box every single time, and then you'll be all set. We've had some pretty high-level cats walk through.